I will defend our democracy, our elections, and the people who do this work every day. And I will fight for nonpartisan redistricting to be the law of the land as long as I'm governor, because it's the right thing to do and it's a promise I made to you. That's why I created the People's Maps Commission, 9 Wisconsinites selected by a panel of 3 retired judges to represent each congressional district and to serve as our state's nonpartisan redistricting commission. They weren't elected officials, lobbyists, or high-paid consultants. They're doctors, librarians, community members, and educators. And they worked hard over the last year to listen to folks from every corner of our state to prepare a set of maps for the legislature and me to consider. But what's sitting in front of me here are gerrymandered maps modeled after the same gerrymandered maps we've had for a decade. Hundreds showed up on short notice to voice their opposition to these maps, and not a single member of the public testified in support of these bills at that public hearing. And they were sent out to my desk over the objections of a decade's worth of people in the state demanding better, demanding more, and demanding a fair, nonpartisan process for preparing our maps for the next 10 years. Elected officials shouldn't be able to depend on the comfort of their seats instead of the quality of their work. And the gerrymandered maps Republicans passed a decade ago have enabled legislators to safely ignore the people who elected them. And these maps here, they're more of the same. They're gerrymandering 2.0. I told the legislature early on to go back to the drawing board when these were first introduced. I've said all along I'd veto these maps if they came to my desk. This was about elected officials having the courage to do the right thing when it mattered most, and the members of this legislature failed to deliver. So with that, I'm now vetoing SB 621 and SB 622.